Happy Election Day, everybody. That's right, it's Tuesday, November 6th. I'm not going to talk about the election. What I'm going to talk about is our ridiculous two-party system. For many years, I was a Green. I attempted to vote Green in every election for every position. However, we didn't have enough candidates, number one. And more importantly, which should be number one, people were not aware of our platform. Our platform was all about preserving and conserving nature and the environment. Now, neither party has really done that. They've all been a paltry excuse for that. I guess we can thank Nixon for starting the EPA. We can deride the rest of the Republican presidents for trying to throttle it or attempting to suck up even further to big oil and big coal and big gas. Well, today, the facts are in. Renewables are more popular. Renewables are better for the environment, even though there's a huge fossil fuel debt to get there. Okay, now on about what I was going to talk about to begin with, which is conservatism. Really, there is no conservatism. Maybe there was at one point, but it's never really done anything good for our country, except when Eisenhower conserved the New Deal. That was conservatism. Nowadays, we have a bunch of reactionary idiots, okay, running around saying they're conservative. They're fiscally conservative. They want small government. They got infected by Reagan bullshit. Reagan was the biggest front man piece of shit we ever had, next to this joke that we have now. Now, these guys are not the problem. The problem is the people that swallow this fucking Kool-Aid. That's right. This conservative Kool-Aid, which is not true conservatism. Now, if they're being conservative, wouldn't they want to conserve and protect the environment? Wouldn't they want to conserve and protect our industries? Wouldn't they want to conserve and protect the people? Wouldn't they be the party of the people? They're not. They never have been. Never since the days of Lincoln, when they had radical Republicans, or the days of Teddy Roosevelt. What's happened in this country is that we've turned into a corporate shill. Now, the problem is not the politicians. The politicians are a reflection of their monetary supporters. They're a reflection of the capitalist nightmare that's destroying the world. That's right. Capitalism is destroying the world because it's taken a wrong turn. Now, small C capitalism is great. Small businesses working with small businesses, consumers buying from these small businesses hiring people. Yes, that's right. Small businesses have more people working for them than any other economic concern. Small businesses are the bulwark of America. The problem is that big business took over. Big business moved the jobs out of the country. It wasn't the fault of labor unions. It wasn't the fault of government. It was big business who decided this because they put profits before people. And they are the culprits. Now, if anything, we should buy locally from small businesses and never buy from large corporations who've moved any workers out of the country. That's right. That's right. If the tariffs were correct, they would be against the businesses, not the country. They would be against the businesses who have moved their manufacturing operations that used to be in this country out of the country. Do that, and they lose American consumerism. Do that, and the small businesses thrive more and more so. And yes, there will be an economic transition period. And yes, we will pay more for American-made, American-produced goods sold by American small businesses, not large businesses. This is really what the problem is. Socialism, okay. We don't really have socialism. We have some effective social programs. We need universal health care for everyone. We need it. We need to nationalize the energy industry so they no longer have power over us. We need to nationalize the oil companies so they have no power. We need to nationalize or make nonprofit the hospitals and big pharma. If we do that, our people can be healthier and safe. This is what we need to do. And yes, now that is socialism. However, true socialism is when the workers control the means of production. Don't see that happening, with the exception of worker co-ops. More and more small businesses need to be more benevolent and start transitioning these businesses into the hands of the workers. Then the workers will control small businesses to a greater extent than now. And that will do nothing but help the economy, as the workers will make more. And when workers make more, they spend more. And when they spend more, it fuels the economy. Okay, so that's about enough out of me. There are no real conservatives anymore. There's just a dangerous terrorist party known as the Grand Old Party. The Democratic Party is so diverse that luckily now progressives are having a big impact. And we can't quit after this election. We need to keep going, going, going after this election. We need to count up our mistakes. We need to improve on our losses and go forward and get these bastards out once and for all.